flyer.
Especially new because Bernie Parent will be honored. He'll get his banner that's been hanging over there at the Spectrum for all these years. Let's check in with public address announcer Lou Nolan.
Ladies and gentlemen,
At this time, please welcome to the ice, joined by his family, Carol, daughter Kim, and number one, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Bernie Perrant. At this time, please turn your attention to the Zamboni Tunnel as members of the Ed Snider Youth Hockey Foundation skate the number one Bernie Perrant banner onto the ice. As lights fade on the famed Philadelphia Spectrum, we reminisce about the teams and players that took the ice in that historic building. Bernie Perrant was more than a player on the Flyers. He was a living legend. From the bumper sticker with that famous motto to the appearances on the covers of Time Magazine and Sports Illustrated, Bernard Marcel Perrant quickly became one of Philadelphia's most beloved sports figures. Perrant was the original Flyer selected in the 1967 expansion draft. He was traded in 1971, but reacquired 2 years later and became the final piece of the puzzle for the Flyers. His play in the Stanley Cup seasons of 73-74 and 1974-75 is widely regarded as being among the best back-to-back seasons by a goaltender in NHL history. He won the Vezina Trophy as the league's best goaltender and the Conn Smythe Trophy as playoff MVP in both of the Flyers' Stanley Cup seasons. He retired in 1979 with amazing career numbers with the Flyers. 232 wins over 486 games, including 50 shutouts, more than twice as many as any other goaltender in franchise history. He was suitably honored on September 25th, 1984, and he became the first member of the Flyers organization to be inducted to the Hockey Hall of Fame. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Philadelphia Flyers, it's my honor to present Bernie Perrant, the very man of the home and the proudly of the Raptors since October 11, 1979. Congratulations, Bernie. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask Flyers captain Mike Richards and San Jose's captain, Joe Thornton, to skate to center ice and join Bernie and his family in a ceremonial puck drop to commemorate this occasion. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you to Joe Thornton.
In the 1984 season, the organization's heart and soul was ready to retire.
And allow me to be privileged to welcome you to this night of nights. First, let me set the tone. No sadness tonight. We want this to be a joyous celebration, not of the end of a career, but the fact that we were privileged to have that career unfold in this city and in this arena.
Clarke is a legend and great player, a good teammate, and well deserving of that kind of an evening. The Flyers deserve that. And he was a very, very big part of everything that happened, us winning.
Please, we implore you, just this once, indulge yourself to the fullest, revel and bask in the glory of tonight's emotion.
It's just a great honor to play with him for all those years, but just the leadership roles, I mean, it's something that's born inside you, and he's a great guy to follow.
How could you not look at his example of leadership and his work ethic, and his commitment to the game and his drive and his passion, and not be inspired by it?
If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have did all the things I had done, because he pushed me to the limit, and he would be always on my back. Come on, Ray, let's go, let's go.
He hated to lose. You're on the ice, he'd give a yell at you, he'd scream at you, he'd spear you. Practice, so he got mad at you. He didn't care. He just, all he wanted to do was win.
That ovation kind of hits you right in the heart at how much he's meant to this Philadelphia area over the years.
You wish you didn't have to go through something like that, because it means the end of playing hockey. And for me, that was the most important thing in my life, other than my family, of course. But when you get an ovation like that, it's so special.
And now, as the number 16 banners are unfurled, I ask you to join me in saying, thank you, Bob, we love you.
Team raises your jersey, it's so special. Those types of things are lifelong memories for you, special lifelong memories.
I will cherish forever this evening, and if I had my choice, I'd love to do it over again.
And finally, Bill, to present your jersey to the other member of that great line, the rifle, Reggie Lynch. One more time. Thank you, Gene, and good evening to the greatest hockey fans in the world. This honor I'm receiving here tonight is the icing on the cake and a reflection on the Stanley Cup years and also a rewarding career. Tonight, I'm sharing this moment with the Flyer alumni and former teammates. I thank them from the bottom of my heart, for they are the man who gave me so much to make this possible. To Mr. Ed Snider and our Flyer family, I am grateful to you, not only for giving me a career with the best NHL franchise, but for the friendships we share. I also extend my sincere thanks to two gentlemen who played a major role in my life as a Flyer. Keith Allen, who I love like a father, and treasure as a friend, Fred Sherrill. A superb teacher and coach who is fundamental in helping us achieve success. To all you fans who mean so very much, my family and I love the Flyers and love the people of Philadelphia. It has not only been a thrill, but a privilege to have worn the orange and black. As I said before, in my heart, I was, I am, and I always will be a Philadelphia Flyer.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, to make this retirement an official, Bill is a Flyer star, as all stars should be in the firmament. The closest thing we have here is our famous celebrity rafter, so if you'll gaze to the top of the building in the two corners, we ask you now to share in the official lowering of the banner, the permanent retirement of Bill Barber, number 7, Philadelphia Flyer.
On December 31st, I had the opportunity to wear my number 2 Flyer jersey one last time at the Winter Classic in front of 46,000 passionate Flyers fans. The chills I got from hearing Lauren and Kate sing God Bless America, and the thrill I got from scoring a penalty shot goal for my granddaughter Ella, they were incredible. To top that, I can only wish that the Red Wings and the Flyers meet here in June for Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Finals. And lastly, to the fans of Philadelphia and the entire Flyers organization, it was my honor and my privilege to have represented your city and your team wearing number 2 jersey of the Philadelphia Flyers. Thank you.
Outstanding.
At this time, the moment we have all been waiting for, we ask Mark and his family to walk to the banner, clip it to the line as we raise his number 2 to the rafters, never to be worn by a Flyers player again.
Classy ceremony, a fifth uniform number retired by the Flyers. It's been over two decades since the number has been raised to the rafters in South Philadelphia. Number two.
Build what he created.
Differences of opinion, and he hurt feelings. It was time to remember the great moments I experienced here in Philadelphia, the friendships I have built in this great city, and the respect I have for the fans of this team. So once again, thank you to the Flyer organization for this incredible honor and to be up with the great names that are up there already. It's truly an honor. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Fans, it's the moment we've all been waiting for. Eric will join his family at the location of the banner as he raises your number 88 to the rafters. Eric Lindros, from tonight until eternity, your number 88 will never be worn by another Philadelphia Flyer. In honor of all the contributions you have made to our organization in the city of Philadelphia, there it is, ladies and gentlemen, number 88, Eric Lindros, retired.